Have you ever wanted to watch something draw on its own?
Yeah, me too. Welcome to Impossible Science.
Hey everyone, it's Jason Latimer, the world champion of magic, coming to you with another Impossible Science. Now, today's topic is, can we get a drawing to animate on its own? And it would be possible if we're talking about cymatics. Now, what is cymatics? Well, it's the study of visible effects of sound and vibration. So, let's get started. Pretty awesome, right? Well, before I can get it explained to why this is actually making those patterns, first we have to figure out what a wave is. So let me explain. A wave represents a disturbance traveling through a medium or space. In this case, the string is our medium. If we oscillate this string up and down, we can see the disturbance as it travels down the string. Now, if we tie the end of this string to a fixed post, when our wave reaches the end, it reflects back towards its source. As expected, if we sent a continuous wave down the string, a continuous wave would reflect back. This would result in two waves moving in opposite directions in the same medium. As these two waves interfere with each other, the total disturbance is just the sum of the waves. When they're on top of each other, they add to each other, but when they're on opposite sides, they subtract from each other. And if we line up the frequency just right, we can make the interaction of these two waves cancel each other out, creating a wave that does not look like it's moving at all. This is a standing wave. The part of the wave that is not moving is called the node, while the part of the wave that is moving the greatest is called the antinode. Now that we figured out what a wave is, let me explain what's going on here. This is a clotting plate. This is actually a metal plate that's been attached to a little pin in the center, and that pin is vibrating up and down through what's called a vibration generator. And over here is a function generator. This is telling the vibration generator what frequencies to go. If I throw sand onto a plate like this, if I adjust the frequency just right so that we can find a standing wave, the sand is falling to the point where the plate is vibrating the least. That's the node versus the antinode. And by adjusting the frequency, we adjust where the waves are crossing. And that crossing, we can see with the patterns of sand, a drawing that's changing on its own. So much fun. Well, there you have it. A drawing can change on its own if you're talking about something like cymatics. You could actually draw a pattern out here, and if you could predict where those nodes would be, well, then you can actually make a drawing change from one drawing to another. Pretty cool if you think about it. Now, if you enjoy making the impossible possible, let me know by clicking the like button and sharing it with your friends. And if you enjoyed the episode of Making Impossible Subjects Become Reality, well, then let me know and subscribe to the channel. And until next time, stay curious, because the right question changes everything.